Good morning, YouTube. Guys, I've been waiting to put this video out for a while now, because, well, not necessarily a while, I just recorded it, but it feels like ages, because I had the most satisfying matchup ever. Guys, for starters, no one likes playing against a food deck. Even if you run a food deck, you don't like going up against other food decks, just because... Anyway, there's no greater feeling then to take out all of the lands from a food deck. We did it. Let's kind of jump straight into it. So here's the list. It obviously still needs some tweaking. Four colors. But with things like Fires of Invention, as you can see here, the mana fixing is a little bit... What's the word I'm looking for? You can be a little bit loose with it. In the sense that once you have Fires of Invention out, then the color combinations no longer matter. It's more so about the total CMC. So, example being Casualties of War requires 6 mana. If you have Fires of Invention out, then you can have an entire land, like battlefield full of just swamps or whatever, as long as it's at least 6 total mana like on the battlefield. So it's really nice as far as helping with mana fixing, as well as being able to cast multiple land destruction removal, such as Rubble Reading, which also helps fix your library, so when you go into your next draw, you can scry 2, and obviously setting up Rawl. Some of the mechanics behind it are utilizing Rawl to both obviously fix your library, as well as being able to duplicate your casts for land removal, so essentially you're getting 2 lands for the price of 1. I'm still toying around with the concept behind running Kevin Malone, aka Kefnet. Kappa. One of the big things I like about him is you get even more value out of each spell, in the sense that if he's on the battlefield and we draw into a Rubble Reading, we essentially then get two lands to destroy, because we can cast the first one for 2 mana, and then we can go ahead and cast the next one for, you know, its full price. So we're getting 2 for 1 there with Kevin Malone, and obviously you're trying to destroy as many lands as possible. Assassin's Trophy, I'm a little bit on the fence about. It's just an all-around great removal card. However, we're trying to remove land, not bring it back to the battlefield. But I've been kind of toying around with the concept of its use in the early game, especially with destroying those dual lands, kind of forcing them to play the one of each colors. But anyway, let's go straight into the actual matchup itself. It's just so good. It's so satisfying. Excuse me, guys. All right, so we've matched up, and we actually do have the Kevin Malone in opening hand, kind of where we were talking about, aka Kefnet. I know you guys are like, Kevin Malone. Come on, guys. Do you guys office much? Anyway, 2 Rubble Readings. This is actually not a great opening draw, but we have stuff to do. We have stuff to work with. I kind of play into my Assassin's Trophy early game theory, especially if he does draw if he does post out a dual mana. We're gonna go ahead and Overgrown Tomb here. And Temple there, so there's the double mana. Initially going to this, looking like Golgari. So we do draw into a Rawl, so that's kind of nice. We're hoping to at least draw into 1 more mana to get everything online, minus Kevin Malone. Blood Crypt, kind of deciding whether or not we want to have Assassin's Trophy open. We actually do test out our theory this time by, I believe, we go ahead and take out that Temple of Melody and kind of force him to decide which route he's going to go on, the black mana or the green mana side. And it's also going to kind of tell us what's in his hand too. So if he decides on black mana, then I'm pretty sure he's got some green in his hand, so we can kind of help guess what he's got. So right now he went green mana, so that means he has black mana in hand more than likely, especially with something like Golgari where you need that black source. Yeah, or a Fable Passage, it works out too. And then kind of contemplating whether or not we're going to end up doing the Rawl. do we actually set up the Fabled Passage now? Which I believe we do. We don't have a turn three play anyway, so it'd be kind of a waste. Well, never mind. We have four mana. We'll have four mana, so we can actually go ahead and do that. It's fine. Actually, the smarter move, in my opinion, would have been the Fabled Passage to set up and put Kevin Malone online. In case we did draw into a blue source, I was just thinking to myself, I should have done a Fabled Passage, because it does require the double blue. And then we'll have more weapons. I mean, if we don't draw into a blue mana, we don't draw into a blue mana. But at least it leaves it open for the possibility of being able to have him online. So we see a Gilded Goose come out, kind of telling us we're going the food route here. Wonderful. At this point, we do have two land destruction in our hand. If we do get the Rawl out, we go into a Fires of Invention. Oh, I'm licking my lips right now, boys and gals. This is what we want to see happen. I'm thinking to myself, do we get Rawl out now? Could we protect them long enough to get two copies of Rumble Reading? I'm thinking about it. So we get Fires out. I'm like, do I do this? Do I do the Rumble now? If I do, I do obviously take the green source, because that type of Golgari, green's going to be heavy for him. Huge for him. So we're going to go ahead and do it. I didn't end up going the Rawl route. Probably because next turn I'll be doing Rawl and a Rumble. So in this case, I go ahead and pitch Kevin Malone. I believe we keep the Chemist here so we can restack our hand. Yeah, we go ahead and keep the Chemist on top. We go ahead and take his green source. So next turn is going to be spicy. Us being able to do a Rawl with the Rubble. And we got to be careful too. But we are lined up pretty nicely. So I think we're going to go ahead and Rawl. Boom. I actually kind of contemplate getting Kevin out too. Because if we do draw into something like Casualties of War, another Rubble Reading or something like that, then we can really get more value out of it. But we're going to go ahead and do the Rawl thing. Take out both of his green sources. Leaving him with only the black mana. I believe he taps it. He should tap his goose and make another food, but it's so satisfying. And I believe we get the double scry too. Yeah, so he does pump out another food. We don't need land. Get that out of here. No, sir. No, sir. No, ma'am. There it is. Some casualties of war. So I'm actually thinking here. So I'm actually contemplating setting it up for the Kevin. So I go ahead and put the mana on top. Because I'm thinking to myself, I could Kevin Malone. Because the next draw step, he won't be on the battlefield right now. So, next draw step, draw the mana, put Kevin out, and then I know Casualties of War is next. So, that way on my next draw, I'll be able to duplicate it. So, that's the thought process here. I don't end up doing that. After I see Priest come out, of all the things to come out, it kind of messes up my Kevin plan. Because, technically speaking, he could get another creature out and then remove my Kevin during his turn. So, I would just be putting him out for cannon fodder right now if I did cast him. So I'm kind of contemplating the right move to make. Do I go ahead and put Kevin out now and let him get killed by Priest? Or do I just hold back and get rid of Priest with just casual? Because Casualties of War could go ahead and take care of Priest too. As well as the Goose. So I'm thinking to myself, which route do I want to go? I think I'm going to go ahead and do Chemist. I think I'm going to play it safe. It's unfortunate we don't get the double cast out of Casualties of War. I think we could have risked it, especially now that I'm thinking about it, with him not having any green sources out right now. He's going to need to keep that goose alive. So I don't necessarily see him sacking Goose for Kevin, but I also still see him sacking Goose for Kevin because Kevin is really good. And it's something that needs to be removed off the battlefield. So I don't know. That's a tough call. You guys let me know in the comments below what your thoughts were as far as whether it was a punt or not. So we go ahead and jam Kevin in there. At this point, we're like, you know what? We drew our casualties of war. May as well see how our boy's doing. And we have a chemist inside with a land in hand, so. He's thinking about it. He knows what's coming. So he does get an incubation druid out. So there's his green source, and as well as the two creatures he needs in order to take out Kevin, if he does decide on doing that. But he doesn't, so that would have worked out in our favor. But you can't really play magic on a who woulda type of situation. So we're gonna go ahead and roll. Something he should have done was pop the priest now, in my opinion, because then he could have at least gotten some value out of it. Because we're obviously going to take the priest here. Do we go artifacts? I'm thinking about, we let him keep his food? I think we take it from him. So creature, land, ping him. It was what, turn 6, and he's down to like no mana now. It's so good. Not today. Get it out of here. Get that nonsense. Get it out. Now, there's no real way of telling if he was like a true food deck or if he's just some kind of Golgari jankiness. We didn't let him play. So, I mean, I saw foods. I saw Goose. So, I'm just going to assume this was a food deck that we're going up against. We were able to push down the gas pedal pretty early in this matchup. He's going to go ahead and throw the towel in, as anyone would. Turn 6, having 0 mana on the battlefield. Go ahead and step into the office for a second, guys. Truly, I had, as you guys can see, I had to share that with you guys. And like I was just saying, I'm assuming it was some kind of food deck. I mean, he had a goose, he's pumping out food. The priest is what kind of throws it off just a little bit. But, you know, we could be seeing that a little bit more in that particular coloring. Anyway, appreciate you guys for tuning in. Here is my social medias. Make sure y'all follow me over on Twitter at Kevin Raisins. Catch my live streams at Scottoria on Twitch, as well as twitch.tv/USArmyEsports. I do stream to that channel during the daytime. And then USAE Scottoria is my Instagram. And of course, if you have a deck that you would like me to play on video or even on stream, post it in the deck list channel in my Discord server. The links are down below in the description, discord.gg/thekillsquad, all one word. And if you're interested in being a part of the United States Army's esports program, we do have an MTG team, which I'm a part of, as well as competitive teams for CSGO, League of Legends, etc., all the competitive games. discord.gg/USArmyEsports, all one word. And yeah. You have yourself a good evening, guys. Appreciate y'all for tuning in. Thank you.